success. And I have learned by the perfectest report that they have more in them than mortal knowledge. When I burned in desire to question them further, they made themselves air, into which they vanished. Whilst I stood wrapped in the wonder of it, came missives from the king, who all hailed me Thane of Cornwall. By which title before, these weird sisters saluted me, and referred me to the coming on of time with, "Hail King that shalt be!" This I have thought good, to deliver thee, my dearest partner of greatness, that thou might not lose the dues of rejoicing by being ignorant of what greatness has promised thee. Lay it to thy heart and farewell. Glamis thou art, and Cawdor, and thou shalt be what thou art promised. Yet do I fear thy nature. It is too full of the milk of human kindness to catch the nearest way. Thou wouldst be great, art not without ambition, but without the illness should attend it. What thou wouldst hide me, thou wouldst holily. Thou wouldst not play false, and yet wouldst wrongly win. Hie thee hither, that I may pour my spirits in thine ear, and chastise with the valour of my tongue all that impedes thee from the mortal round, which fate and metaphysical aid doth seem to have thee crowned withal. What are thy tidings?
The king comes here tonight.
Thou art mad to say it. Is not thy master with him, who were so would have been formed for preparation?
If you please, so it is true, our thane is coming. One of my fellows had the speed of him, who, almost dead for breath, had scarcely more than would make up his message.
Give him ten. He brings great news! The raven himself is hoarse. The croaks the fatal entrance of Duncan under my battlements! And on mortal thoughts. Unsex me here. And fill me from the crown to the toe, top full of direst cruelty. Make thick my blood. Stop up the access and passage to remorse, that no compunctious visitings of nature may shake my fell purpose, nor keep peace between the effect and it. Come to my woman's breasts, and take my milk for gall, you murdering ministers, wherever in your sightless substance you wait on nature's mischief. Your face, my thane, is as a book where men may read strange matters.